Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the show. Do you believe in miracles? I do, and so does Errol Brown from Hot Chocolate. But tonight, history is about to be made here in this theater. I must ask you all now to look at the strange apparatus in the center of the stage. Focus your attention directly onto it. This is where science fiction becomes science fact. Joe Pasquale is about to materialize from the very circle of power right in front of your very eyes into the center of the stage. You are about to witness a 21st century miracle. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Joe Pasquale!
You've got to admit, that would have been a bloody good trick if I could have done it. Would it? Look at me, I could see all your faces. Look, if anyone blows off, I know who's done it. Is it going to be great? Lady, I've got to say, I'm so excited. I've never been here before. And there's 2,200 people here tonight, and I didn't think any bugger was going to turn up at all, and you didn't. So I'm glad you did, or else I would have got arrested for talking to myself. I'm glad you did, but out of the 2,200 people, I bet there's some people here tonight that don't really want to be here, though, right? I bet some of you are only here because somebody else wanted to come and they didn't want to be on their own. That laugh says I'm right as well, they're done. And those people are sitting there like that, they go, oh, God, I've got to sit for an hour and a half of this cat. So I understand what you feel, especially if you're sitting next to people you don't know. You can't be yourself, can you? You can't relax if there's someone strange sitting there, can you? You know, there might be like six of you in a party and somebody's going, go and love you, get in there first. They say, go and get in there first. And they go, well, why don't you get in there? Just bloody get in there, will you? And you had a big row before the show started, and you don't know who you're going to sit next to, do you? It might be somebody nice and attractive, mightn't it? On the other end, it might be some great big fat sweaty mini bloke blowing off all night. You don't know. No disrespect, sir, but you don't know. I'm not saying you are. I don't know. But as you sit down, your knee might rub against his. Oh, I touched his knee. I don't know what to do. And the worst thing is, you don't know which arm rests yours either, do you? No one tells you. Go, oh, which one's mine? Is that mine? Is that yours? Or is that mine? Yeah, but if that one's yours and the fat bloke's got mine and I haven't got one, and you're there for 2 hours and you have to wait until he scratches his ear, then you nick it off him like that, so I understand, but don't get depressed, right? As long as we all have a laugh, that's what's important. As long as we all go, ah-ha-ha-ha. Preferably all together makes it a lot easier for me, but I am... I just get rid of this old pack here, Lee Desmond. Because, you know, I've actually been on the... Oh. Stage fright, because I've actually been on the internet, right, and done a bit of research. I've found out that everybody's name in the British Isles has an old English meaning, and I'm going to put my research to the test tonight. So that bloke right down the front there spent all day doing his hair and come out without it. If you tell me... He's not smiling. If you tell me, sir... If you tell me what your surname is, I'll tell you what the old English Saxon meaning your name is. What's your surname, sir? Cartle? Cart Hill? It's not bloody A-level this is now, isn't it? Sorry, it's not as my year in. Car Hill. Oh, Car Hill, you see? I just put a T in the middle of it, Mr. Car Hill. Well, Mr. Car Hill, he'll be pleased to know this, Car Hill actually means good-looking and attractive, so that's nice for you, isn't it? And what's your first name? Alan. Oh, that means not very. Oh, that's a bugger for it. Sorry, Alan. Give with that and a check. I know what I've got for you, Alan. As a little bonus for you, I'm going to do a card trick. Here I have for you, Alan, I have a rubber chicken with a playing card inserted into his anus, right? Now, the Latin term for this is rubberus maximus chickenus cardus up the jaxius. And if you tell me any card you like, Alan, I'll guarantee that's the card in the chicken's anus. What card are you thinking of, Alan? The Jack of Spades, and he said the Jack of... Let's have a look for the Jack of... Let's see, don't want to give it up tonight, Alan. Hang on a minute. Come on, let it go. You can have it back later. There's a little bit of a pop there. Let's have a look. You said the Jack of Spades. The card in his bottom is the Seven of Hearts. But trust me, ladies, one day somebody's actually going to say the seven of hearts, and when they do, it's going to bring the... Because this is my job. Playing with rubber chickens is my job, right? Because I've got the sack from everything else I used to do. I used to be a long-distance lorry driver on the Isle of Wight. Then I was a plumber for 146 years, but that's just an estimate. Then after that... Then I was a tour guide in Vatican City. I was actually inside the Vatican, right? And I was showing people round, telling them about the Pope. And he walked round the corner. I went, oh, speak of the devil. So that didn't last long. But my favourite job, right, was working in a sausage factory. And I got the sack on my very first day, ladies and gentlemen, in the sausage factory. Even though I was very good on the chipolatas, right? I'm now going to explain to you the circumstances behind my dismissal from the sausage factory. This is why I got the sack. Yeah, you like this move, don't you, love it? Hi, my name is Joe. I've got a wife and two kids, and I work in the sausage factory. One day, the boss said, Joe, are you busy? I said, no. He said, pull the sausage with your right hand. Hi, my name is Joe. I've got a wife and two kids, and I work in the sausage factory. One day, the boss said, Joe, are you busy? I said, no. He said, pull the sausage with your left hand. Hi, my name is Joe. I've got a wife and two kids, and I work in the sausage factory. One day, the boss said, Joe, are you busy? I said, no. He said, pull the sausage with your right foot. Hi, my name is Joe. I've got a wife and two kids, and I work in the sausage factory. One day, the boss said, Joe, are you busy? I said, no. He said, pull the sausage with your left foot. Hi. My name is Joe. I've got a wife and two kids, and I work in the sausage factory. One day, the boss said, Joe, are you busy? I said, no. He said, pull the sausage with your head. It's not what you thought it was going to be, though, is it? Hi, my name is Joe. I've got a wife and two kids, and I work in the sausage factory. One day, the boss said, Joe, are you busy? And I said, no. He said, pull the sausage with your tongue. Hey, my name is Joe. Right, and I went, in the sausage factory. My name is Joe. Are you busy? I said, yes. And that's why I've got the sack. I've got all this in here. What are you going to do? What I'm going to do now, do my favourite. Oh, listen, Lee, I've just had some bad news about my granddad. Apparently, my granddad's come back from the doctor's this week. He can only get excited by putting his willy in a hot mug of water. It's not my cup of tea. So what I'm going to do, what I'm going to do, I'm going to do my favourite trick of all time. This is my favourite trick of all time, ladies. Now, once I've done this, you'll know why it's my favourite trick. Normally, I get two people up to help me. I have one person holding this side of the rope, and one person on that side, right? But to save time tonight, I'm going to do it all on my own, like this, right? Now, what happens, please hold your applause, what happens now, I split the audience right down the middle there, so if you just close your legs, love, and pick a side, that would be great, right? And what happens... it's complete cack, isn't it? So what I do, right? If I point at this side of the rope, everybody in this side of the audience, right, all on the levels up there, you have to go, oh. Okay, let's try that, thank you. Oh, very good. Now this side, I'm going to point it, everybody over here has to go, ah. Okay, have a little quiver to it, helps, all right, ready? Go. Now if I point to the middle, everybody in unison has to go, okay, let's try that one now. You really should get out more, shouldn't you? Okay, now stay with me, right? Starts off slow, but speeds up. Remember the little quiver in the voice. Ready? This side, start off first. Ready? Go. Very good. Now this side. Even better. Come on this side. Yeah. Ah. Ooh. Ah. Ooh. Ah. Ooh. Ah. Ooh. Now we're going to have to give it 20 minutes before we do that again. I've also found, listen, on the internet, I've found there's a website for incontinent people, which is great news for a lot of us. Well, not me personally, but you know it's me. It's great news, right? Because if you are incontinent, just visit the website, which is Okay, what else? Oh, this is great. A lot of magicians do this trick as well, right? What they do, right? You have a big table like this, right? And all glasses on it with a tablecloth. And you grab hold of the tablecloth right there. And you pull it really quick. And all the glasses stay there. And once I've done it, everybody go, wow, that was amazing. Okay, give us a drum roll. Ready? Give me a drum roll. Ready? Okay, three. But first, a song, ladies and gentlemen. A song dedicated to any mathematicians we have with us in the audience tonight, and the song is entitled Subtraction. So take it away! See, subtraction. It's gonna be a bloody long night. This is a nice tune right there. I'm doing comedy this side and tragedy over it, because you know, I've had my hair cut for a film, so I'm going to the pictures tomorrow, so that'd be good. And I'm actually going to see remakes of films, My Left Foot and Free Willy, and it's called My Free Foot Willy, so that's quite nice. So I know what we'll do a card trick this time, ladies and gentlemen. We'll do a great card trick. What do I want? Yes, I want somebody to pick a card. Yes, that nice, attractive, chunky bloke down the front. If you pick a card for me, sir, pick a card, any card you like, that's it, in your own time, that's it. You're a strangely attractive, chubby-fingered man, that's it. Look at the card for me, sir. Look at the card there. Okay, remember the card? Put it back in the deck for me, you chubby-fingered love monkey. Okay. Remember the card for me, sir, because I made a prediction earlier on today about what card was going to be picked by a chubby-fingered man in the front row. I think you're fine, sir. We're at the shadow of a doubt. That was the card you just picked. That correct? The Three of Spades. Bugger. What was the card you picked? The Four of Spades. So we're just arguing over one missing spade. Sort that out, smart ass. Look at that. What else you got? I know what you do. I'm gonna do some impressions for you now, right? This is my first impression. Ready? Oh God! Yeah, that's definitely me. Look, that's my nose. There, look. Oh, sometimes I do that too hard. When I do it too hard, it really hurts. Watch what happens when I do it too hard. Okay, quick impression there, Lydia. This is my impression now of a bloke walking along the beach eating a box of popcorn. Okay, so what do you call a Frenchman walking along the beach with a pair of sandals on? Philippe Philop. It's line dancing. I know what I do, Nelly. I'm going to do some body popping for you, Nelly. I'm going to make my body go pop, right? Because I found out by someone else come on then. What happened then? I'm going to do some professional body popping because I found out by accident, ladies and gentlemen, but I was having a public toilet, right? I was having a wee, right? And a strange phenomenon happened to my body. It's a very strange phenomenon. Phenomenon. Just the anticipation's making you laugh, no? Phenomenon. What happened, right? I was having a wee and it made a funny noise. It went snap, crackle, pop. Right? It also smelt of Rice Krispies. And I could hear Tony the Tiger going, "They're great." I thought, that's not quite right. So I went to the doctor and said, "Doctor, whenever I have a wee, it smells of Rice Krispies." I could hear Tony the Tiger going, "They're great." And he goes, "Snap, crackle, pop." He went, "That's a strange phenomenon." I said, "Yes, it is." He said, "Does it hurt?" I said, "Only when the little plastic toy comes out." So, I'm going to do some professional body. Can I have some body popping music for the ladies and gentlemen? Here we go, ladies. Oh, yes, your favourite bit again, love. This one's called the pepper grinder. This is the fax machine. Sauce bottle. You don't give a monkey's, do you? Okay. I'm going to make my body go pop, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to be wildly amazed by this once it's happened. Don't try this at home, all right? Do it next doors if you want to do it. Here we go. Oh, God! Come on! I had rubber shooting up my nose then. Not the first time this happened. Okay, give me a drum roll. Give me a drum roll. Ready? Drum roll. Three, two. But first, another song. Yvonne Goolagong, what's a lovely name? Yvonne Goolagong, what's a lovely name? Yvonne Goolagong, what's a lovely name? Better than Bjorn Borg. Okay, so what we do, Nelly? Oh, you know what you want to do? Try this one. I go to the cinema, sit in the front row of a cinema at a horror film, right? And put this wig on. And when it gets to a really scary bit, just go, "Wah!" That'd be great. Because, you know, when I was little, right, I used to go to the pictures a lot on a Saturday. And Saturday was a big day for me because I used to have a bath on a Saturday as well, right? And because I've got two sisters and one brother, but my sisters have got two brothers, I don't know why that is, right? But I used to have my brother's bath water once he'd finished with it. Did anybody else used to have their brother or sister's bath water? Yeah, but I used to have it on me cornflakes. It was horrible, right? So what I used to do, I used to sit with a towel wrapped around me and listen to Robinson Crusoe on the radio, right? And it was my favourite programme as a kid. And we're going to do one of my episodes, my favourite episodes now, right? But on the radio, they have a sound effects department, right? And we haven't got that here, so I'm going to ask you now, ladies and gentlemen, you've got to be the sound effects tonight, all right? So if anything comes up, if you're like, "Oh, I can do that sound," just dive in. Don't worry about any miserable bugger sitting next to you not joining in. Just go for it. Please go for it, because otherwise I stand here looking like a div all on my own. Now, I will be using my theatrical actor's voice, so please don't be alarmed when it comes out. Hearken, all ye shipmates. A can't believe I get away with this. Hearken, all ye shipmates. A tale I tell to thee of mystery and danger that what happened
once to me.
With a quick blast of me foghorn. Very good. At 1:30 we departed. I remember the time exactly because it was when Neighbours had just started. Yeah, I'd bloody leave that, thank you. For 7 nights and days we sailed, the wind full at our backs. Then suddenly it did get calm and we stopped dead in our tracks. We're on a boat, you silly bugger. It's not Formula One, is it? You don't see the QE2 pull out going, "Oh!" You get skid marks on the water. Then from out of the clear blue sky, an albatross did appear. That was very good. That lucky charm for all at sea, so we gave a great big cheer. Oh, so you'll do the bloody easy ones, don't you? With that poor bugger struggling on the albatross going, "Meow!" It swooped down low upon our decks. Thank God, the captain said. No, he didn't bloody... Well, give me a chance. And as I removed my hat to pray, it pooed upon my head. That was a hell of a poo, that one was, wasn't it? This angered me, and red with rage, my gun, I went and got it. No, I just picked the bloody thing up. It's got a hair trigger on, is it? and fixed the albatross in my sights and jolly well went and shot it. So you cocked that last bit up then, didn't you? All at once our fortunes changed. The weather, it turned nasty. Oh, I'd only caught out in that without me coat, I'll tell you. The thunder cracked. It's like group therapy for divvy people, isn't it, eh? The rain lashed down. And the wind became quite blasty. Somebody had to do a farty sound there, didn't they, eh? Oh, when morning came, I found myself upon the beach awaking to the sounds of tropical birds. Tweet, tweet! And the waves around me breaking. Somebody went breaking, somebody went slash. Then on my desert island I did live for many a year, till one day in the forest a strange sound I did hear. You're so inventive. A howling wolf. A hissing snake. Or maybe a hyena's laugh. Could it have been an elephant's trumpet? Or maybe a giraffe. Sort that one out, snarl. What else? Oh, listen, you know what it was? No, look, I've got to show you this, ladies and gentlemen. I've got to show you, I've got one of these. Everybody's wearing these bangles, these bracelets now, these rubber bracelets, and they all signify different charities, right? And I've got a blue one which signifies bullying, right? But I didn't actually buy it, I just nicked it off a little kid in the car park. But at least I'm supporting them, aren't I? Because, you know, I've got really nosy neighbours. My nosy neighbours, like, always looking over the fence like that. So what I've done, I put a big high fence up so they can't see over it. But the only thing is, I can't see over at them there. So what I've done, I've got my own invention to enable myself to do that, right? And what you have to do is to look over people's fences, right? You put this safety helmet on, like this, right? Oh, snap! Still not smiling, right? Then what you do then you put these special glasses on as disguise, right? Look. Oh, I wonder who that is now. Look, he's just moved glasses on, right? Then, when you want to look over the neighbour's fence, right, you get this cardboard box, right, and you put it over your head like this, right? You put this on, right? Then you sneak along the fence. Sneak along the fence, pull the safety screen down, right? And when you're level to wherever it is, when you're level, when you're level in the garden, all you want to do is just push a button and go, wee! You know, listen, the other day, I went down the Sea Life Centre the other day and I found out in there valuable information. Apparently, a blue whale can actually hear a mating call 200 miles away. Imagine swimming 200 miles and you get there and she says, I wasn't talking to you. Imagine that. So what, oh no, we're just magic nearly. I'm going to do a trick now. I'm going to show you the first trick I ever learned. Well, it's not the first, it's the second. The first one was pull my finger, right? But this is the second, right? And all it is, right, you have a red handkerchief and a yellow handkerchief, right? And you put them in a bag like that, snap your fingers and there, magically, the yellow handkerchief has turned red. And the red handkerchief has turned yellow. But that's not the end of the trick. I place it back in the bag. I snap my finger. Now the yellow handkerchief that turned red has magically gone back to the original colour of yellow, and the red handkerchief that turned yellow has gone back to the original colour of red. Now I'm going to explain to you how to do that trick, ladies and gentlemen. All you need to do this trick is a bag like this, and you also need two duplicate sets of handkerchiefs. And then you can do it there. So now you do some. We do some proper magic. Now, can I have some magic music for the ladies and gentlemen, if that's all right? A bit louder, that's it, yeah. Hold it, stop it a minute, stop it a minute. It's not bloody Chas and Dave does magic, is it? You don't get David Copperfield going, everybody go, oh, Dave. We'll try it again, thank you. You're not taking this very seriously tonight, are you? Oh. Oh, yes, ladies and gentlemen, a classic piece of magic, ladies and gentlemen. A fantastic, classic piece of magic. This is the amazing torn and restored newspaper. Yes, classic piece of magic, ladies. A classic of magic, ladies. Yes. Yes, another classic, ladies and gentlemen, this time, ladies and gentlemen. This is the amazing cups and balls routine, ladies and gentlemen. This is the cups and balls routine for people who are short-sighted, ladies and gentlemen. I place the ball under the middle cup. Now keep your eye on the cup. Remember, the hand is quicker than the eye. Oh, which one could it be under, ladies and gentlemen? Is it this one? You're correct. Could it be this one? You seem very sure. You're correct. Could it be this one? No, it has disappeared completely, ladies and gentlemen. Never to return. Now, the amazing disappearing candle, ladies and gentlemen. Disappearing candle. Now, look, I'm going to prove to you that the hand is quicker than the eye, because here we have a hand, and here we have an eye. Let's see what the quickest is, shall we? And they're off. Oh, yes, it's the hand. Okay, yes, ladies, it's next time for the amazing lovey-dovey. This is the amazing lovey-dovey. Lovey-dovey. Lovey-dovey inside the cage. This one, ladies and gents, this is called the Haunted Sausage of Sainsbury's. Oh, grow up, for God's sake! Yes, ladies and gents, my haunted... sausage on a stick and that sort of thing. Yes, amazing lovey-dovey, ladies and gentlemen. Amazing lovey-dovey. Amazing lovey-dovey. One, two, three. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I think I've got a touch of that bird flu coming. I know what you're doing. It's next time for a lovely song, a song dedicated to all the lovely children we have with us in the audience tonight. Lovely song for all the lovely children in the audience. Lovely song, all the lovely children. I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride. make it easier. Let the children's laughter. It's only bleach, okay? I know what to do. Another song there, Leslie. This time, it's a lovely song dedicated to all the lovely ladies in the audience, all the beautiful women tonight, and it's called Easy. And it goes like this. Thank you. And if you know the words and you want to join in, don't, because I want to do it on my own. It goes like this. I know it sounds funny, but I just can't stand the pain. Girl, I'm leaving you tomorrow. Seems to me, girl, you know I've done all I can. You know I beg, stole, and I borrowed. Yeah. So I'm easy. Oh my God, look at that foxy mama down the front. I'm easy like Sunday morning. Yeah. I bet she's begging for it.
Oh, yes.
So I'm easy. I'm easy like Sunday morning. Oh, for Shandy, and she's mine. Why in the world would anybody put chains on me? Yeah, but she likes being tied up and all. You know, I paid my dues to Mickey. I think she fancies you. Everybody wants me to be what they want me to be. Who do you want me to be? Brad Pitt or his brother Sess? I'm not happy when I try to fake it. Show your nuts. Yeah.
That's why I'm easy.
I'm easy like a Sunday morning. Yeah. I'm having a party in my pants and you're the only one with a ticket, baby. Didn't know it anyway. I'm easy like a Sunday morning. Go and give her a flower. I wanna be high. So high. I wanna be high. So I think I love you. I wanna be free. Oh, you're so manly. Just me. Yeah. Come on, get your axe out. Get your axe out. Show them what you're made of. Right. Go on, get it out there, big boy.
Got it, got it.
Make a noise like a man.
Ew!
Moist mean anything to you? I'm easy. Get up, go over to her. Right, I'm going. I'm easy like sunny morning. Yeah. Let her get a good waft of your pheromones. I'm easy. Yeah, I can see her nostrils flaring.
Easy like sunny morning.
Yeah. The key change. Get ready, squeeze the nuts. Get out there, big boy.
That's why I'm easy.
Oh, yeah. It's like Sunday morning. Yeah, you nailed that one.
Yes, I did.
Go on, go over and kiss her. Bend over and kiss her.
Okay, kiss her.
Oh, no, she's got a bogey hanging.
Thank you, anyway. Thank you.
Yeah. nice and clear off of it. Just pull that now, is that all right? You've been a really good sport, you foxy lady. What's your name, you hot piece of totty lady? Jill. Jill, can I call you Jill? Yeah? When's the best time? Jill, what I'm going to do, if that's all right with you, I've been to see David Essex in concert, right? Yes, you see, and they know what I'm going to do, because he's a very foxy bloke as well. And what he does, I'm going to do, right, because he sits right down the front like this, and he makes eye contact with one beautiful woman, and he sings to her. And that's what I'm going to do tonight, Jill, OK? So could you swap seats to that lady there with the blonde hair? No, I'm only joking, I meant you, Jill. It's right if I sing to you the way David does it? Yeah? OK, I will then, love. That's what I do then. I'll do what David does. Can't remember what he does with his legs. As long as they're down there somewhere, that's all that matters, really, isn't it, Jill? OK, see what David does, ready? Hey. I saw a mouse. Where? There on the stair. Where on the stair? Right there. It's a little mouse with clogs on. Oh, well, I declare. Going clip, clippity, clop on the stair. Right there. What stupid mouse should have put his slippers on? No one would have heard him coming, Jill. Then he would have.
What's that? Turn it off. Shut up a minute, please. Turn it off. What's going on? Turn the bloody thing off, will you? Hello? Is it still on? Turn the bloody thing off. It makes me sound ridiculous. Shut up. It always sounds like that. Just turn the bloody thing off, will you? Turn it off. Turn it off. Don't look at me like that.
Is it off? It bloody is, isn't it? 3 million unemployed and I've got a dickhead on the sound. Can you believe this? OK, Jill, you've been a really good sport so far. I've got one more question to ask, one more favour. Would you do me the honour, Jill, right, and be my assistant in the next part of the show for me? Would you do that, Jill? You would? Yes, you'd come and give Jill a big round of applause. Thank you, Jill. Well done, Jill. Thank you, love. That's it, Jill. That's it, love. Use the stairs, that's it, Jill. Thank you, that's it. You're a foxy lady. Normally, I just get some old trout up, but not tonight. It's great. Thank you, Jill. Just sit there, love. Oh. Bit of a farty sound as you sat there then, Jill, wasn't it, eh? I'm not saying it was you, love, all right? It's just you and me up here, and it wasn't me, all right? OK, Jill, before we start, thank you for getting up. This is going to be an experience of a lifetime that you'll never forget, all right? OK, Jill, I've got something special I want to ask you now, Jill. I must ask you, have I ever been round your house before, Jill? No, that's right. You'd remember me if I'd been round there, wouldn't you? And you don't remember me, do you? What about now? Don't you remember me now? Eh? I'll remember you, you soap-on-a-rope lady. OK, Jill, we've got some bits to do here, Jill. First of all, Jill, I want you to take hold of that gun, love, OK? Put it in your right hand, and then aim it at me. Don't pull the trigger, just aim it at me. That's it. I want you to make it like you're angry with me. Go, ah! Do it loud. Yeah. But it's been a long time since you made a noise like that, isn't it, love? OK. OK, Jill, if you just point the gun at me, love, point the gun at me. That's great. Make sure you've got a grip on the handle. Great. OK, just take that off you now, love. I'll take it off you. Okay, what else have we got? Have I done this yet, Jill? Shh. Have I done this yet? Shh. No, I'll do that now. Shh. Okay, Jill. What have we got here, Jill? Now, Joe, I must ask you, right? It's very important, this. It's very rude of a man to ask a lady how old she is. So how much do you weigh? Okay, Joe. Want you to, right? Do you remember these from school? Yeah. These are like personality tests. Do you remember these? Yeah. And because I've just met you, I don't really know what you're like, but this is a good judge. These are scientifically proved to be quite accurate, Jill. So what you do is pick a colour for me, Jill. Any colour you like.
Yellow.
Y-E-L-L-O-W. Now, pick a number.
Eight. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Another number.
Four. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
One more number. Number one,
we'll
read what number one says, right? Hope it says something nice about you, okay? Don't expect it will, though, love. Oh, Jill, you are smelly farty, lady. Sorry, love, it doesn't lie, but don't worry. We've got time to redeem ourselves, because over here, Jill, I have something very special. This is something I call the piece de resistance over here, Jill. Or, as they say in France, the piece de resistance. This, Jill, is the knife board of Decepticon. Okay? Now, we do have with us tonight a French interpreter with us, because we have some French people in the audience. We'll explain to the French people as we go along.
Bonjour.
Yes.
Bonjour, bonjour.
Yes. Jill, this is a position I'm going to require you to assume in a few short moments' time, okay?
Le position assume, Jill.
Yes. Now, once you're in this position, I want you to relax and enjoy the experience, okay, Jill?
Once in position, relax, enjoy, put the punish on my lever.
Yes. Once you're in this position, knives are going to be thrown at each one of these balloons. The balloon will then pop, and the knife will then be embedded in the wood behind. But you will remain unharmed.
Knife thrown at balloon, balloon go bang! Renault Clio.
But don't worry, I want you to relax and enjoy this, all right? Because it won't be me throwing the knives, it will be a professional knife thrower. Spent 12 years in the circus doing this, ladies and gents. To be honest, I only kept him on for 12 years because he was the only one who could get the tent back in the bag. But he is here with us tonight. Ladies and gents, you probably know him better as my twin brother. Ladies and gents, please give a big round of applause to my psychic twin brother, Reynard, ladies and gents. Big round of applause to Reynard. Come here now. Where are you, son? Yes, please. Yes, ladies and gentlemen.
Danger!
That's right.
Danger!
It's danger, that's right.
Danger!
He is an ugly sod, isn't he, eh? Beauty skin deep is inside out. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, that's right. This is my twin brother. As you can see, we're not identical twins, as we were split up at birth and Reynard was brought up by a tin of skipjack tuna.
Tin of tuna?
That's right. This is Jill. Say hello to Jill.
Hello, Jill.
That's right. Stop sniffing her. Don't sniff her.
Go on.
No, he's as stupid as he looks, ladies and gents. He is. He just bought himself two pet goldfish. He called one one and the other one two. So if one dies, he's still got two.
What?
Just go and get the knife, all right?
Get the knife.
Get the knife. I want Jill to relax and enjoy this so she has confidence in what we're doing. Not that one, you div.
Not that one, no?
No.
The other one.
Get the other one.
Okay.
That's it.
That's danger, Jill.
That's right.
Jill, danger.
That's right. I want
danger.
You to...
Danger.
Spanner face.
Danger.
I call him Spanner Face because every time I look at him, my nuts tighten. What I want you to do...
That's why I wondered.
That's right, sorry, Jill.
Sorry, Jill. Sorry, Jill.
I want...
Danger.
Oi!
What?
I want you to show Jill why we call you Dead Eye Dick. Yeah. So she knows... No, you know what I mean!
Go on!
With the knife, you spanner. With the knife.
The knife.
The blue one here. Throw the knife at the blue one so it pops a balloon and goes in the wood, remember?
The blue one. What one's the blue one?
This one.
Danger!
Yes. The blue one. There's no wind in here, you div, is there?
I've got a check.
He fell out the ugly tree and hit every branch on the way down, didn't he? Just throw the bloody knife.
Oh, bit out it was.
Just go and look after Jill. I'll throw the knives tonight. You could have killed me then, you monkey spanker. Oh. Just take her over there.
Come with me, Jill.
Go with Reynard, Jill. He'll look after you. That's it. Well done, Jill.
That's danger.
Just assume the position, love. That's it. That, oh, yeah, you've got a bit of a low gusset there, haven't you? That's it, love. Don't lean back, it'll fall over, lover, OK? It'd be funny, but don't do it. That's it. OK, now, what we want you to do is just relax, all right? Don't flinch. It's important that you don't flinch, all right? Cos that could be very dangerous if you flinch. Stop it. Don't, the best way of not flinching, Jill, right, is to be blindfolded, all right? If you blindfold Jill...
Oh, great.
Yeah, remember what we did before?
Yes.
That's it.
No, she won't be here.
No, her hair's fine. It's like plastic padding. That'll be fine. It's not the first time you've had that done, Jill, is it, eh? Okay.
Snooker ball?
No snooker ball, no.
Gaffer tape?
No, no gaffer tape, okay. I want you to make sure that Jill can't see anything while I get the knives ready, okay?
Certainly.
Make sure she can't see nothing with the knife. Okay. Make sure she can't see, and I'll be with you.
See and learn, see and learn. That's your advert.
Yes, that's right, it's my advert.
The whole universe has disappeared.
Yes, that's right.
It's gone.
Yes, yeah, gone, okay.
My name's Barry Scott and this is Silly Bang. Bang in the dirt's gone.
Right, what?
Lime scale.
That's right.
Soup scum.
Forget about the bloody soap scum. She's got a bag over her head. Just make sure she's relaxed, all
I'll
right?
Make sure she's
she was
relaxed.
Being very patient there. She looks like the crazy frog in that position, but it's good. Just make sure she's relaxed and enjoying the experience for me, Ray. Okay?
Jill, are you relaxed? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, put it down there then.
Okay, Jill, put it down.
No, I'm talking to you. Put it down.
Put it down.
Yes. Put it down.
Put it down, Jill.
No, I'm talking to you.
You're talking to me?
Put it down.
Talking to me.
I'm talking to you.
Talking to me.
To you.
To me.
It's turned into the bloody Chuckle Brothers now. Put it down.
Chuckle Custard.
No, forget the Chuckle Custard. Put it down.
Put it down.
Put it down.
Do impressions.
I'm trying to do the bloody show here. Forget the impressions.
Go on, just one.
Well, just do it then, do it. What's that?
A ghost.
Right, now put it down.
Got another one.
Go on.
Ooh.
What's that?
It's a grizzly bear.
Yeah, very good.
Got another one.
Go on.
Ooh.
What's that?
A polar bear. Got another one.
Oh, hurry up. What's that?
A gummy bear.
That's very good. Now put it down.
Got another one.
One more.
Can I see your licence, please, sir?
What's that?
A bent copper.
Put it down.
A bent copper.
Yes, I see it. Put it down.
That's a bent copper.
Yeah,
Jill.
I got it, yeah.
It was
fun.
Really funny if you'd have seen it.
Okay, Jill, we're going to do this now. Just relax, love, all right? Try not to shake.
Just relax.
Yeah, not you, you div. I'm talking to Jill.
Talking to Jill.
Okay, Jill, we're going to do it.
Danger!
Okay, Jill, we're going to do this now.
Going to do it now.
I'm going to have myself up. Ready?
Oh.
Here we go, Jill. Here comes number one. Ready?
Number one.
Ready? Wow!
Ah! Oh. Oh, that was close, Jill. Oh.
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
Here comes number two.
Yeah, I think I can smell it. Mushy peas.
Stop it.
Ooh.
Stop it! Here it comes, Jill. I'm going to do this. Ready, love? Here's number two. Ready?
Ah!
Oh. Ooh.
That was close.
Yeah. Okay.
Danger!
Don't worry, Jill. I know what I'm doing, love. Okay, Jill. Here comes number three, Jill. Ready?
Ah!
Oh.
Oh. Oh, it fell out!
Okay, Jill. Here comes number four, ready?
Number four, danger.
Ready, Jill?
Ah! Ah! Oh. Oh.
Oh, God.
Oh, that was close, Jill.
OK, here comes your favourite one, Reynard.
Jill, this is... Jill, this may sting a bit.
He said that to a few women before, haven't you? OK. Here comes the last one, Jill. Ready? We're home and dry after. So... Leave us a big round of applause for Jill. You survived, Jill. You've done it, love. Your hair looks fine. You've done it. Wait a minute, give me a paddle. That's it. That's enough. Okay. Take her back to a chair there, Reynard. Give Jill, she can go down that way or that way, whatever you may prefer. That's it. Make sure she's all right. Well done, Jill. Well done. Thank you, Jill. Jill, you've been a really good sport tonight, and I've got something for you, OK? I've got you a balloon animal, right? I'm going to make you a balloon animal now. But it's been a long time since someone made you a balloon animal, isn't it? How long do you reckon? Long time, is it? How long, love? Long? Really long? Oh, using the wrong end. Not really, I always use my mouth. Okay. Jill, what I'm going to do, right? I've got one already blown up for you. I'm going to make you an animal of your choice. Anything from the animal kingdom, because I could do every animal there is. I could do a dog. I could do a zebra. I could do an elephant. I could do a dog. I could do a chimpanzee. I could do a dog. I could do anything. What sort of animal do you like? Anything? A dog. You want a dog? Now, go on, give me something difficult, because I want something different. Something challenging tonight. Give me something challenging. What do you think? A gorilla. You want a gorilla? Okay, gorillas are fine. Is he a happy gorilla or is he a sad gorilla? He's happy, that's good, and I know why he's happy. Do you know why he's happy? He's happy because he's going to a party. Guess what sort of party he's going to? Fancy dress party. And look, guess what he's going as? He's going as a dog! And that's for you, Jill. Thank you, Al. Thank you, Jill. So what I'm going to do now... I'm going to do something a little bit strange now. Look, well, not that the other stuff isn't strange, but this is a little bit different, right? I'm going to do a painting for you now. It's a painting of my nan and granddad, right? Because my nan and granddad were great. And, well, you know, I liked them a lot. You know, they were great. Whenever I go to the cinema, it always reminds me of them because the names were Pearl and Dean. I used to call my granddad Grandpa, Papa, 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 Papa. Grandpa, Papa, Papa, Papa. And to be honest with you, I miss them a lot, as a lot of us do miss our grandparents. And I wish now that I'd spent a lot more time with them when I was younger. But it's too late now because they won the lottery last month. They don't want anything to do with me, so I'm going to do a painting there of my nan. Well, it starts off as my nan, then it ends up as my granddad, which might sound a little bit weird, but you'll understand what I mean by the end of it, though. Because they were nice to me when I was little. You know, one year they said to me, what do you want for your birthday? And I said that I wanted an action man. So on the day of my birthday, I opened up the box they gave me, and inside was a little man, pulled the string on his back, and the little man went 5, 10, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 65, 67, 70. I said, what's that? They said, it's auction man. And I got a bit older, I wanted an interest in different things, so I wanted a skateboard, and my nan and granddad said, no, you can't have one of those. They're far too dangerous, you hurt yourself with that, maybe when you're older. So the following year, I said, can I have a skateboard this year? I said, no, still too dangerous. You'll hurt yourself, maybe when you're older. And this went on for about 10 years, asking for a skateboard. And each year they say the same thing, too dangerous, you hurt yourself. So when I was about 14 or 15, I had some money for my birthday. So I went down to B&Q. I bought myself a big piece of wood about 18 inches long, 6 inches wide. got some wheels and screwed them to the bottom of it. And I went round my nan and granddad's house and bashed them over the head with it. Said, you're right, they are dangerous, aren't they? From then on, I was never quite sure of our relationship. I was never sure how much they loved me after that. They took me down to see the Lions of Longleat in an antelope skin jacket. And a roast chicken in each pocket. I used to have hand-me-downs as well to go to school in. Because I was the eldest, the only person's clothes that would fit me was my granddad's. So I used to have to go in the playground with a cardigan, slippers and a pipe. And a catheter. And I remember I had a girlfriend about that age as well, and I was never sure of girls. So I thought I'd ask my nan about it. So I said, Nan, what is love? She said, well, it's big and it's round and it's green. You cut it in half, it's red in the middle and very sweet to eat. I said, is that what love is? She went, oh, no, sorry, I thought you said a melon. She was on medication at the time. My granddad was just a stranger. He was an Elvis impersonator. But there weren't a lot of call for that in 1938. He was famous, though, for shooting down two German planes. But he did that in 1954 as well. But see, it's my nan. She had a bit of a witchy poo face, you see. But it turns into my granddad in a minute. You'll see what I mean soon. And it was about that sort of age as well that my nan knew that I wasn't going to fit into normal life, because even when I was born, it was a bit strange, I came out of the woman in the opposite bed to my mum. She knew my job weren't going to be normal as well, so she sent me off to singing lessons. And after a while, after I'd had a few, she sent me off and I had to enter a talent competition to sing her favourite song. And I remember it like it was yesterday.
Django's annual dance for you, with worn out shoes, with silver hair, a ragged shirt, baggy pants. He would do the old soft shoe. He would jump so high, jump so high, and then he'd lightly touchdown. He told me of a time he worked with minstrel shows, just traveling throughout the South. He spoke with tears for 15 years. How is Dog and he? Well, they just travel about, but his dog up and died. Oh, just got up and died. And after 20 years, he still grieves. He said, I dance now and every chance in honky-tonks for my drinks and tips. Most of the time, I just spend behind his county bars. You see, son, I drinks a bit. And then he shook his head. Oh, Lord! And when he shook his head, I could swear I heard somebody say, please, please, oh, Mr. Bojangle, I'm calling Mr. Bojangle. Hey, Mr. Bojangle, come back and dance. And dance, and dance, please dance. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles. come back and dance, and dance, and dance, please dance. Oh, 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 oh.
Gentlemen, Mr. Joe Pasquale. Joe Pasquale, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for the one, the only, Mr. Joe Pasquale, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Joe Pasquale.
Okay, Lisa, you've been really nice. I do like to give out presents to people that have taken part in the show tonight. I've got some bits and pieces here to give out. So, Jill, down the front, would you like this? You can have this. This is for you. Is that all right, Jill? I've got your bingo dress on, I noticed. Eyes down, looking. That's nice. Okay. And who's that man sitting next? Is that your husband there? Just a friend of the kids? That's your friend. Okay. What's your name, sir? Glyn. Ooh, nice name. OK, Glyn. I've got something for you, Glyn. Something for Glyn. Is that right? OK. And Mr. Carl Hill, would you like that? Or would you prefer one of these? What would you like? Choice is yours, Mr. Carl Hill. You want that? I'll leave these up here and you can have that. OK, is that lady with you as well? Yes, yeah, she's kind of that. That's mine. I look, love that one's yours. That's yours. Is that all right? Yeah? I'll show you mine, you show me yours. Go on, show me. Go on, show it to me. Show it. Oh, you dirty bugger, I knew you'd do it. And what else? There's a couple of kids, a little boy down there. Got look. Oh, no, I've got nothing left for the little boy there. That's a bugger, isn't it, mate? I'm sorry. I know what to do. Glyn, can I swap? Can I swap? Thank you, Glyn. Here you go, mate. It's not often you get something for nothing round here, is it, eh? And that's for you, mate. Well done. Hello, gents. Lisa, do something a little bit different, a little bit special now, because magicians, you might see magicians in the past, they make animals appear in their acts. Some magicians might make, like, a rabbit appear from a hat. Some might even make, like, a dove appear from a handkerchief. Some might even make a mountain goat appear with some Wellington boots. But that's another show completely. So tonight, before your very eyes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm now going to make appear from behind this cloth, ladies and gentlemen, a fully grown Australian 18-foot man-eating crocodile. You don't give a monkeys, do you? Who goes? Speaking of monkeys, there's two monkeys in the bath, and one went, woo, 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 and the other one said, put some cold water in then. Who goes? 18 foot Australian man-eating crocodile. Now, I have to say, ladies and gentlemen, there can only be one survivor on this, OK? It'll either be me or him. I eat him or he eats me. OK, one. I also want to say, ladies and gentlemen, you've been a fantastic audience tonight. You've been lovely. Thank you very much for being so nice. And I think, right, if you really work at it, you could go all the way. I do. You could end up at the London Palladium, all right? But don't do what a lot of audiences do, which is they just as they go out the door, they split up and never see each other again. That's a real shame, all right? You deserve better than that. Okay. Okay, listen. But I love you too. I understand. It's me mum. Okay. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. On the counter. Also, ladies and gentlemen, this is a... I want to say, down the Sea Life Centre, I found out valuable information. Apparently, a shark will only attack you when you're wet, which is something worth bearing in mind. If you ever go swimming in the... Oh, God! Do you hear what I said? I said sharks will only attack when you're wet. Bloody hell. Sympathy for you now after that hit. Okay. Bloody funny. Okay, here we go, then, ladies and gentlemen. On the count of three, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, also, ladies and gentlemen, this crocodile is a man eater, but he only eats ugly people, okay? So most of us are going to be all right? Glyn, you might want to move back a few rows. Here we go. One last thing. I meant to say this a little while ago. I've said a lot of things tonight that I didn't mean in jest, ladies and gentlemen. It was just a joke. A lot of stuff I really didn't mean, OK? Like just now, Glyn, I said that I implied that you was ugly, all right? I didn't mean it, all right? And Mr. Carl Hill, right? I said earlier, I pointed that, I said you was a slaphead, didn't I? And I didn't mean that, okay? And the lady over there, I just spat some water out, I didn't mean that. Okay, and Jill, down the front there, I said you was a foxy lady. I didn't mean that, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. 18-foot crocodile. Start the music now. 1, 2, 3, go. Only one, ladies and gentlemen. Only one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joe Pasquale. Mr. Joe Pasquale, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, everyone.
Let's hear it one more time for the one and only Mr. Joe Pasquale, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Pasquale, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Joe Pasquale.